Hello students, good morning everyone. So in last class we have started a new topic in our unit 2, that is theory of attributes. So we have discussed the introduction part, that what is attributes and how to write the attributes, how to represent those attributes, and what are the different combinations we can write by using the attributes. So I said you all to write the different combinations of three attributes. So hope you all have written that one. Now, what does theory of attribute means? It deals with the qualitative data. Attribute means a quality of a characteristic. So whatever the quality of an characteristic that are regarded as attributes. Now, in the last class, we have discussed about the class and class frequency. So what is class?
A, B,
beta, gamma like this. If you have three attributes in a class, here we have three attributes in a class. So that's why it is called a class of order 3. So here the order is 3 because we have three attributes. So this is called the order of a class. That means a class represented by n attributes is called the class of nth order. If you have two attributes, it is called the class of order 2. If you have one attribute, it is called the class of order 1. Similarly, if you have three attributes in a class, then it is called the class of order 3. Similarly, if you have n attributes, that class is called a class of order n. So this is about the order of the class. So these are the different class frequencies under different orders. Now we will see what are the different class frequencies we are going to get according to the order of the class. So if you have the order 1, how many class frequencies you will get? If you have the order 2, what are the different class frequencies we are going to get? Similarly, if the order is 3, how many class frequencies we will be getting? So like that, we will see the all combinations now. So first, order. Next is an attribute. The next is the class frequencies. So if I consider an attribute, only one attribute. So whenever we start with attribute, if you consider one attribute, what are the different class frequencies you get? And one thing you have to remember is, for all the attributes, whenever you consider attributes, capital N is the common attributes. What is capital N? It is the total number of values. So you may write any class frequencies, but the capital N is common. So first write capital N. Next, for A, what is the class frequency? Class frequencies are written with brackets, that is in brackets you will be writing A. So for attribute A, you will have the complementary attribute also. What is the complementary attribute? Alpha. So only if you consider one attribute, you will be getting these combinations only. One is N, that is common thing, and A and its complementary attribute alpha. So here we are getting only three class frequencies. So what is the order here? If you observe, the order is, we are considering only one attribute, so the order is 1. Similarly, if you consider the two order, that means we are considering two attributes, one is A and the other is B. So what are the different class frequencies you can write here? One is capital N, that is common. What are the different class frequencies you can write? First A and its complement alpha. Next B and its complement beta. And whenever you have two attributes, you will have the different combinations also like that. AB, A beta, alpha B and alpha B and alpha beta. Now, so we may get confusion. If you observe for order 2, that is for two attributes, how many class frequencies you are getting counted? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here, total class frequencies are 9. So this is for the order 2. Similarly, you check for the order 3 also. So remember, you consider order 3 means you will have three attributes, that is A, B, C. So if you have three attributes, write down the different combinations. First is capital N. So these are combinations for two attributes, and you can also write BC. You can write BC and B gamma also. I've written with A. I've written with B. So you can write BC, B gamma also. Next is you can write alpha with alpha also. That is alpha C and alpha gamma. And the next is two combinations are finished. Next you write three combinations. That is you will write ABC. First is you write ABC. Next remove the A and write alpha. For remembering purpose I am saying, in place of you write complement, that is alpha BC. Next you can write alpha beta gamma. You have written ABC, right? Next you can write A beta C. You can write alpha B gamma and alpha beta gamma and alpha BC, alpha beta C. You can write alpha beta C, you can write alpha beta C also. Alpha B gamma, yes, alpha beta C. So check it. Alpha A beta gamma. You didn't write, you have written A beta C, but A beta gamma you didn't write. So now count, if you want, you once count all the values. So we have written alpha B C, but it's reverse, that is alpha beta C we have not written, and also alpha B gamma also. Now count the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, and one more value is missing. Once I'll check it out. So all the three combinations we have written, and the two combinations I forgot to write, beta C and beta gamma. We have written BC, right? So for that BC, you have to write the complement beta C, and we have written B gamma, the complement we didn't write, that is beta gamma. So these are the different combinations or the different class frequencies we will get when you consider the three attributes. So in last class I said to do one homework, right? So you have to write all these class frequencies or these classes you will be getting for the three attributes. So count, you will be getting total 27 class frequencies. You will be getting total 27 class frequencies. So whenever you consider an order, then these are the different class frequencies. So if you consider the order 1, you got 3 class frequencies. If you consider the order 2, you got 9 class frequencies. Similarly, if you consider the order 3, you got the 27 class frequencies. So whenever you have n attributes, so what is the number of class frequencies we are going to get? So number of class frequencies are 3 power n. So you will get, if you consider one attribute, 3 power 1 is, you will get 3 class frequencies. If you have 2 attributes, 3 power 2, you will get 9 class frequencies. Similarly, if you consider 3 attributes, 3 cube, you are going to get 27 class frequencies. So this is the order of the class and the different class frequencies under the order of the class. So the total number of class frequencies of n orders in the starting classes you may be feeling little bit difficult in writing the attributes. So don't get confused. Just with a peace of mind, write the attributes carefully. So because it is a confusing, I understand, but you have to be very clear with it. Don't get confused. And the next is, I'll say the contingency table. Next topic is contingency table. So what is this contingency table means? You will have for different orders, you will have different class frequencies, right? So if you write all the class frequencies in the form of a table, that is called a contingency table. So contingency table means arrangement of all the class frequencies. Arrangement of class frequencies in a table is called a contingency table. So, if I consider the order 1, so whenever I consider order 1, you will be getting how many class frequencies? 3 class frequencies. So that means that can be written as A, you will be writing like this, A, alpha, N. So these are the different class frequencies we are going to get for order 1. So from this you can write that these are always indicate the totals. So these indicate the classes. So for class A, the class frequency is, you will write in the brackets. For class alpha, you will write the class frequency alpha in brackets and the total A. So that class frequency of A plus class frequency of alpha will be equals to capital A. So similarly, if you consider the order 2, if you consider order 2, how many class frequencies you are going to get? 9 class frequencies. So how we will arrange those 9 class frequencies, we will see now. So first what you will be writing is, you write 2 attributes. See, order 2 means you will have 2 attributes. So what are those 2 attributes? A, comma, B. So first here I am writing the attribute A and its complementary attribute alpha beside it. Here I will be writing the attribute B and its complementary attribute beta. And in the last line you will be writing the totals. Here how we have written A and its complement, then total, like that only, A, alpha, its total. Similarly, B, beta and its total. Now if you observe, so first, if you observe this, you check the, what is this cell? This cell is an intersection of attribute A and attribute B. So what is the class frequency we will write here? A, B. Here you will be writing, it is an intersection of alpha and B. So you write here alpha B. Next, it is an intersection of A and beta. So you will write the class frequency of A beta. Similarly, here it is an intersection of alpha and beta. So write the class frequency alpha beta. So coming to the totals, totals means you can write, one simple thing is you can write it is the total of the row B. So it is the total of the class frequency capital P. So one thing you can write like this, or you check this too. So from this two attributes AB and alpha B, what is the common thing? B. So you can write B here. Either you can add this two to get B, or simply you can write it is the total of B. So you write the class frequency of B. So it is the total of beta, here we will write the class frequency beta. Or if you check like this, A beta plus alpha, a beta plus alpha beta is a beta plus alpha beta. What is the common thing? Beta. So here you will be writing the class frequency beta. Similarly, if you check column wise, a b a beta. What is the common thing? A. So it is the total of the class A. That is class frequency A. This is the total of the class alpha. You will write the class frequency alpha. What is this one? The total. So always an attribute plus its complement. Or attribute plus its complement is nothing but capital N. So this is called the contingency statement. So here I took the two attributes. So this is called a 2x2 contingency table. It is called a 2x2 contingency table. Now, from this table, you can write the relationship between the attributes. So how to write the relationship means? So I said how we are getting this B. This B equals to by adding these two values, that is AB plus alpha B. Similarly, how we will get beta? This beta equals to A beta plus next one is alpha beta. Similarly, how we will get A? A equals to AB plus A beta. Based on this two attribute concept only, we are going to draw the third contingency table. So for three attributes, that is n equals to 3, you will get how many? What is the order? So the order is 3. So you will be getting the class frequencies. That is, class frequencies you will be getting 27, that is 3 square. Sorry, 3 cube, because the order is 3. Power 3, 27 class frequencies. So how those 27 class frequencies are arranged in the form of a contingency table, we will see now.
Next, after A, gamma.
Now totals. Have you write the totals? By adding these two, you will get the total here. So have you had A, B, C, A, B, gamma. So I said how to remember by taking the common terms. Here the A, B, C and A, B, gamma. What are the common terms? A, B. So here you will write A, B. Similarly, the total A, beta, C, A, beta, gamma. What is the common term? A, beta. Next, similarly, total for the column wise, here A, B, C, A, beta, C. What is the common things? A and C. So the class frequency will be A, C. And similarly, here the common things are A, gamma. Now if you observe, what is this? This is also the total. That means you can do total for this two or total for this two. If you observe, AB and A beta, the common is A. Similarly, AC and A gamma, the common is A. So here the total comes A. Now similarly, write for the remaining also. So come here, alpha, B, C, next alpha, beta, C, next alpha, B, gamma, alpha, beta, gamma. Now do the totals. Common things are alpha and C. Next is alpha and gamma. Here the common things are alpha B. And here the common thing is alpha beta. And here the total is alpha. Now coming to the last one. So this is important one, that is you are doing the totals only. So here you will be doing the totals. So for this two columns, for this two rows, A and alpha, you have to do the total and write here. So if you observe, in the first box, what is the value? A, B, C. So for A, first box A, B, C. And for alpha, the first box is alpha, B, C. So what is the common thing? B, C. Similarly, you see, check this one and the second one. A, beta, C. And alpha, beta, C. Common is beta, C. You can write like this. And one more thing is, the simple remembration you can do. Here you have B, here you have C. So you can write BC or you can write beta, C. So similarly, if you check like that, you will get B, gamma here. And beta, gamma here. You can add like this also. The first cell here and the first cell here, or you can directly see the totals of B and C can be written as BC. And the next is last totals. If you observe, the common for this two, BC and beta C is C, or you can directly write the total of the C column as C. Here B gamma or beta gamma, the common is gamma. So this is the gamma total. Class frequency of gamma. Similarly, here if you observe BC and B gamma, you can write B, and beta C and beta gamma, you can write beta. So now the total. What is the total? Here the totals is to add all these, because this last row, last bar, last box is about the totals only. So always the grand total is capital N. So you will write here capital N. If you observe, you will get all the 27 boxes. 1, 2, 3 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 3 is 27 class frequencies we got here. So this is the contingency table for the 3 by 3 contingency table for 3 attributes. So how to write the relationship between these attributes? Similarly, for 2 attributes, how we have written? What is AB? AB means how you are getting AB value? By adding these two values. How we will write AB equals to ABC plus AB gamma. So whenever you have AB, you have to remember that common thing will be AB. So you will write AB as it is. What is the third attribute? So C here, gamma here. So remember like this. So similarly, if you write A beta, so we know that the common thing is A beta. So you write the common thing as it is. What is the third? is also alpha b. Alpha b equals to alpha b c plus alpha b gamma. Similarly, alpha beta equals to, by adding these two values, that is alpha beta c plus alpha beta gamma. This is up to here. Next, how you'll be getting these values? You can get like this also. I have written only the row wise totals. If you want the column wise totals, that is AC. Suppose if I want AC, how we will write AC? ABC. So we know the common thing is AC. So we have written one AC plus here someone AC. What is that remaining attribute B? So you get ABC plus A beta C. Remember like this. Next is, if you want A gamma, how you write A B gamma plus A beta gamma. So similarly, this one alpha C, if you want, how you write alpha C? Alpha C equals to alpha B C plus alpha beta C. Similarly, the next one, alpha gamma, how you write alpha gamma? Alpha B C plus alpha beta. Gamma, right? Alpha B gamma plus alpha beta gamma. So these are the combinations we are going to get the relationship between class frequencies and the class intervals. Next, I have written only up to here. Now the next one, how can we write? Check it out, how to write the next one. Since I want only single attribute totals, that means I want only A for suppose. So how we are getting A? Either by adding this two or by adding those two. So A equals to AB plus A beta is one formula for A. Another thing, we can obtain A by using the row totals also, that is AC and plus A gamma. So this is the one way of getting A. And here if you observe, you are getting this A value by taking these totals, right? If I add this two, I am getting A. But how we are getting these two values? By adding these values. So the A can be written as a combination of that four classes, that is four frequencies, that is A, B, C plus next one is A, B, gamma plus A, beta, C plus A beta gamma. So this is one way of obtaining A. So if I want alpha, similarly if I want alpha, how I will write? Either I will add this two or I will be adding these two values. Or I can add these four values to get the alpha value. So this is the obtaining A and alpha values. Similarly, how to get B value? So here, when you are having B total, here, how you are getting B? By adding these two values. So how you are getting these two values? If you add this one and this one, you are getting BC. Similarly, B gamma means you are adding this same value, right? This one and this one. If you add these two, you are getting B gamma. If you add this first value and this first value, you are getting BC. So if you add 1, 2, those values, that is these 4 values, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you add these 4 values, you will get B values similarly. First thing is, remember how you are getting this B value. So this B value I am getting by adding these 2 values. So how I got these 2 values? By adding. Have you got, this is the first value, right? First value, how you are getting? The first value in the first box, the first value in the second box. So if you have to add this two, and how you are getting this value? By adding second value in the first box and get second value in the first box. So add this two, you are getting B gamma. if you add all those four values, you will get similarly the frequency B also. The similarly the frequency C. Now if I want the frequency C, how I am getting the C? By adding this column and this column. Now we'll check how we are getting these two columns. By adding 1, 2, 3, 4. So C1 is easy. For C, you can simply write BC plus beta C, or you can have to write BC plus beta C, or you have to add this 4 values. So it is a column total. So C total means 1, 2, 3, 4. If you add all these 4, you will get C. Similarly, gamma means if you add 1, 2, 3, 4. If you add this 4 values, you will be getting the gamma value also. So this is the procedure of finding A, B, beta, alpha, C, gamma. And we have seen the two combinations also, how to get the two combinations. So two combinations you can get in terms of 3. And the single combination values, alpha or A or alpha, you may be getting by using two class, two variables, that means two attributes, or by using three attributes also. So this is about 3 by 3 contingency table. So when I send the notes, write and try to recollect this video and write the contingency table and try to write all the relationship between the class frequencies carefully by your own. So once you understand this box, it is very clear to write the relationship between class frequencies. So whenever they ask you to write the relationship between class frequencies, is first you have to draw the contingency table. So if you know how to write the contingency table, by observing that contingency table, you can write the all the observed values, that is the relationship between the class frequencies. Relationship means what? You are finding one value in terms of other values. That is the relationship. So this relationship between class frequencies is very helpful in finding the missing observations. So this is for today's class. Keep practicing this contingency table. We'll continue in the next class.